The new 8 o'clock on CNN. Parker Spitzer, weeknights on CNN.
Tonight we discuss the single most important issue framing these midterm elections. What role should government play in getting us out of this recession? And let's face it, there are two fundamentally different views of that. One, the Tea Party Republican view, which says government should do less, and the Democratic view, which says government has got to do more.
A new movie opens tonight. It's called I Want Your Money, and it's a conservative argument for dramatic cuts in spending. The film being released just 2 weeks before the midterm election. Any way you look at it, it's a political statement. Let's take a quick look at a clip from the film.
So, what you doing here?
This, oh, I'm redistributing the wealth. I learned in school spreading the wealth is good for everyone.
Well, I learned from real life that it's not. What about the guy you're taking money from?
Okay, so it's good for 75% of the people. Isn't taking money from one person to make three others happy a good thing?
No, it's a very bad thing. In fact, there's a word for it. It's called theft.
But it will better the lives of three-fourths of the people.
Actually, it will make life worse for 100% of the people. And we call that socialism.
I can't stand how all you conservatives say socialism, like it's a dirty word.
That's funny. I feel the same way about how you liberals use the word capitalism.
You know, I just got to say, it's not just that this is bad propaganda. This movie makes a mockery of history, a mockery of economics. I know it's going to be all over the country. I'm just kind of curious who's behind it.
There are many things that are misleading about it, but it does speak to a larger concern, and you know, certainly in conservative circles, that the government is expanding at too rapid a rate. We're spending beyond our means, et cetera, et cetera. We all know the arguments. What I'm more interested in is the fact that the conservative side of the aisle has finally caught up a little bit with Hollywood. This is mm-hmm. essentially the mirror image of Michael Moore, mm-hmm. if not maybe as soundly.
Not quite as vitriolic.
Yeah, exactly. Well, there's that.
We saw pieces of it. It's cartoonish, quite literally. I mean, cartoon characters mixed in with real interviews. But what bothers me, you're right, this is the conservative response to what, frankly, Democrats in Hollywood have done very well, which is to use film as a medium to make a political argument.
I wouldn't say
this doesn't do it, though.
Well, you know, the Republicans and conservatives have long felt, and justifiably so, that Hollywood is essentially a propagandist arm for the Democratic Party. Well, no, because look, no matter what you say, we can all agree that most people in Hollywood tend to be more liberal. They tend to belong to the Democratic Party. And the evidence of this is that there are conservatives out there who essentially have formed an underground community because they're afraid to come out in the open.
Kathleen, I will even concede that point to you, but I'm going to say right now that isn't what worries me or concerns me. What worries me is what happens to our economy. And what I see as the argument of the Tea Party and the Republican Party is so disconnected from fact, from history, from economics, that it worries me that its appeal is going to be expanded by a cartoonish film like this. Again, we don't even know who financed it, who's behind it, and I think that's a shame.
Gosh, did you take a Valium? I've never heard you speak that slowly.
You know, I'm just trying to get my arms around. We had fun.
May I just tell you what I'm mostly concerned about?
Yeah. And the answer to the question is no, but that's all right.
The left has its films, the right has their films, and everybody, to me, it's a political coagulant. And I worry right. that we will simply harden our views as we go along. This film is, you know, we know that there's some historical inaccuracies in mm-hmm. it, but it speaks to the people who want to believe this particular message. And I am philosophically more attuned with the conservative right. view than the liberal view when it comes to these things. But I get turned off very quickly when I hear words put into someone's mouth that were not true.
That's right. For instance, this movie calls President Obama a socialist, and I think
that's
just
Obama
so...
Well, Obama says, basically, right, socialism is good.
But here's what bothers me, and I know you make fun of the way I love numbers. The reason I love numbers is because they're facts, and I think if you drill down to facts and a real understanding of economics, then the answers that make sense begin to appeal to everybody. And it isn't quite as simple as big government, little government. It's a government that believes in markets, competition, integrity out there, which requires government do some things, but not others. And if we talk about it in that common sense way, not like this cartoon character film, then we can bring everybody into that one point.
Well, I can't disagree with a word you said. I know I'm supposed to, but that was a very rational statement you just made.
You know, I should
rare,
quit right there.
But rational.